It's that time. Hello viewers, I'm Simon Preston and welcome to Reggae Boyz Commentary. And yes, this is indeed the video where I'm going to show you how I would shape up Jamaica for the first World Cup qualifier against Mexico at the Azteca and how we should approach teams in Central America. Now let me just lay everything on the table first. Mexico is not a Central American country, so it's a North American country, okay? And how I'm going to show you how I think we should approach Mexico is how I think we should approach almost every single one of our home games. I'm going to show you that first. Afterwards, I'm going to show you how I think we should play on the road against Panama, Honduras, Costa Rica. All right? Assuming that Panama will join Costa Rica and Honduras in the final round. But to start the video, I'm going to show you the starting 11 that I believe can get us 24 points out of a possible 42 in the World Cup qualifiers and get us third, at worst case scenario, fourth. All right? Well, I have the team here in my hands, but I'm going to show you on the whiteboard. All right? So let's talk about that 11, and then we discuss about players that might you don't see in the 11, but will form valuable parts of the core moving forward. All right, so let's have a look, shall we? All right, don't worry about the bottom just yet. Right now, I want you to feast your eyes on this, okay? This right here. This right here is a 4-3-3 formation. This is the starting 11 that I have gone with for Jamaica against Mexico at the Azteca in September, and also the starting 11 that Jamaica should utilize as best as possible for a majority of our home games. So, without further ado, here we go. Andre Blake in goal. Undisputed number one, and he will be the man between the sticks during the World Cup qualifiers. Amal Knight, Dwayne Miller, they'll form as understudies throughout the World Cup qualifying campaign. Andre Blake, he is our number one. 4-3-3 at home and selected games on the road. Center halves, Damian Lowe, Adrian Mariapa. Left back, Kemar Taxi-Lawrence. Up and down and up and down, providing support to the front three, and also in certain scenarios providing an option of pass towards the holding midfielders. Right back, I've gone with Greg Lee. Yes, I know his most natural position is over on the left, but he certainly has the ability to play almost as equal, whether as a number six or as a number two, which is the right back position. We saw him against Saudi Arabia, and I feel that he gave a 7.5 out of 10 performance, or at worst case scenario, 7 out of 10 performance throughout those two games. He'll also provide the attacking thrust of the team and being able to provide towards the front three. I know you guys are already asking, well, where is this guy and where is that guy and where is this guy and where is that guy? We'll get to that quite shortly, but we're speaking specifically for the Mexico game. Mariapa already has that experience of the Azteca, has played Mexico on numerous occasions already. Damian Lowe has also played Mexico on a number of occasions already. And we know Taxi already against set pieces, where he has scored even against Mexico at the Gold Cup in 2017. Now, this will be the first World Cup qualifying campaign, I believe, that we won't have with us Rudy Austin. So who I think should come into that number six position? His name is Isaac Hayden. Isaac Hayden of Newcastle United will do the dirty work, will protect these guys at the back, and will also provide an outlet of possession here, 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 and sometimes even here. A wide range of passing, as you can see. The only challenge that I have with Hayden is sometimes the decision making that he would make in this area. But in terms of winning back a possession from the opposition, this guy has all the elements together. Isaac Hayden. Just in front of him, I've gone with Daniel Johnson and Ravel Morrison. Daniel Johnson, as you remember, played much deeper in the Saudi Arabia friendly internationals. But I've gone with Daniel Johnson much, much higher. You need him much higher up the park. He has to, at place minimum, play as a number 8, somewhere in this vicinity, or as a number 10. Number 6 is too deep. Not that he can't do a job, but Daniel Johnson has the ability, the presence, 2 feet, to be able to support the front three and be able to score. Remember, this is a guy that has double digits goals and assists in the championship. A player, in my opinion, that should be playing in the Premier League without a shadow of a doubt. And we know Ravel Morrison, what he brings to the occasion, right? DJ, we know, is like a distributor. This guy, clever footwork, quick feet, and will unlock the doors for him, him, and him. So without further ado, the front three. Leon Bailey Baller, Rolando Ahrens, and Ivan Toney. Rolando Ahrens will cut into his right foot and take a shot on goal. Leon Bailey will cut into his left foot, and like we saw for Bayer Leverkusen against Hoffenheim, this guy also has a solid left foot. I'm telling you, Leon Bailey, you can put him on the left, you can put him on the right, and he'll still find opportunities for you. And through the middle, perhaps one of the most hottest number 9s right now in England. His name is Ivan Toney. You want a goal? You go to this man. You want a ball in the box and you want somebody to head it into the net other than Jamil Matt? This is your guy. You want a guy to stick his toe out? This is the guy. You want a guy to take a shot from outside of the box? This is your guy. You want a guy that can just put the ball on his chest, turn, shoot? This is your guy. This is your guy, Ivan Toney. So that is the 4-3-3 that I've gone with. I expect with the balance of the squad that we'll have, and in addition to the new additions to the squad, we generally will have 4 at the back. Quite rarely, we may have 3 at the back, but I don't foresee it, to be honest with you. Maybe to mix things up a bit, or maybe to experiment during the Gold Cup, but I don't expect 3 at the back. But 4-3-3, 4-2-3-1, 4-2-2, 4-1-4-1 will form the fulcrum of our formations during the World Cup qualifying cycle. So this is what I expect at home and against Mexico during the World Cup qualifiers. Well, how should we approach things on the road? Well, that is also an intriguing question. Let's have a look, shall we? Now, before we look at the formation on the road, let me just put this out there. Jamaica does not have a good record on Central American soil. Okay, Jamaica has only defeated El Salvador and Nicaragua. That's 2. We've only won 2 games in Central America on Central American soil in World Cup qualifying. El Salvador 2004 and Nicaragua during the 2018 qualifiers in 2016. That's 2. Well, it was 2015, wasn't it? Yeah, 2015. So my point is quite clear. We cannot afford to drop any more points on the road. So what do we need to do? At times, we're going to have to be pragmatic to get the points. And how do we do that? We'll find a way to get the best out of this guy. Andre Blake in goal. No question marks there. I've gone for Alves Paul at right back on the road, especially on Central American soil. The reason why I've gone with it is Powell will ensure that he will intercept, tackle, and at the same time, he will find ways to go forward. So that is where I would say he has the slightest of edges on Lee on that right-hand side, because on the road, Powell has that experience of playing on Central American soil as well. So I'd go with Powell in this regard if he's able to find a club and play consistency heading into the qualifiers. Gone with Adrian Mariapa and Damian Lowe. However, if this guy, Alves Powell, is not playing club football consistently, then in comes a guy by the name of Moore, Liam Moore. And then Maps would scoot over to the right back position. And as we know, MAPS has the highest pass accuracy and completion percentage in the CONCACAF Champions League. High 90s. So wherever MAPS is, with a centre half, right back, he won't lose the ball for us. And once we have the ball, the opposition can't score. It's as simple as that. Damien Lowe keeps his spot. Kimar Taxi-Lawrence as well also keeps his spot. Holding midfield. Remember, in previous campaigns, we had Marvin Elliott and Rudolf Austin. But for this, I've gone with Hector and Hayden. And they will offer a much quicker presence. Both tall individuals, but players that can advance the play much quicker. When Austin or Elliott was on the ball, you'd be like waiting 5, 6, 7 seconds to make a pass. But as soon as this guy and this guy get back the ball, whoa, look at that. Trust me, that's a good omen, not a bad one. So the point is clear. As soon as these guy and this guy get the ball, they will look in front of them. And who better to give the ball to than this guy? This guy is a gem. Do we really need to say more about him? This guy, Ravel Morrison, is a gem. Leon Bailey as well, on the right. On the left, I've gone with one of two players. If we're in a situation where we know we're going to be struggling for possession, I'm starting Deva Orgil. Because he's a guy that will work tirelessly, will work tenaciously for possession in these areas, these areas, these areas, these areas, these areas. He will hunt the fullbacks of the opposition. He'll hunt the wingers of the opposition to regain possession, give the center forward, and boom. But in games that I know that we will have possession on the road, then I'm going to go with Bobby Reid. And up top, Corey Burke. Corey Burke, they call him Scory Burke. Without a shadow of a doubt, we're going to get set pieces. And you want a guy who's 6'3" to head the ball in the back of the net. All right, guys. So there we go. Home and away for the qualifiers. So let's look at things, shall we? Just putting the board down for a moment. So guys, I know you've been asking a lot of questions, and I know you guys right now are saying in the comments, well, what about Kevin Lambert? What about Michael Hector? What about Andre Gray? What about Kemar Roof? What about Javon East? What about Deva Orgil? So Gray will still be part of the squad. I just don't have him part of my 11. Lambert will be part of the squad, but just not part of my 11. I spoke about Liam Moore already. I spoke briefly about Orgil. And I know you guys are saying, what about Roof? Roof will also be an option when he gets his passport. But if you ask me right now, who would I want? And I know it's a difficult chance. The man on form right now is Ivan Toney. That could all change in 9 months from now. But the qualifiers were tomorrow. That's exactly what I would go with. So Reggae Boyz fans, let me know your thoughts in the comments below about these lineups, these formations, these tactics. And give me your thoughts about the 11 that I've decided for on the road, the first game against Mexico. Your thoughts about that 11. And let me know in the comments below. How would you change it? What is your 11? How would you play your best 11 for the qualifiers? What would you use? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Alright guys? And if you want more videos like these, just message me below if you want to see. Look at how Jamaica could line up with a 3 at the back. How Jamaica could line up with a 4-4-2. You know? Just let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And I can work on a system that could be quite fluid. Where you have a lot of freedom for players to express themselves and can prove to fruition, and we can get the fruits of our labors. Alright guys, thank you very much for tuning in to Reggae Boyz Commentary. Really, really appreciate it. And don't forget as well to subscribe to Reggae Boyz Commentary. Cool.